remember the great soul Mother Teresa and to give her tribute. I felt, let us remember the great human beings we come across. So that is a big tribute we can give to Mother Teresa when you remember great human beings, giving dignity to human life. As it is said, it would be tragic if the laws and ethics in society are so petrified they are unable to respond to the unending challenge of evolutionary and revolutionary changes in our society. In that respect, it is important to draw a roadmap for the continuous evolution of our society and the legal system in an integrated way for giving dignity to human life, which is crucial to national development. Friends, every citizen in the country has a right to live with dignity. Every citizen has a right to aspire for distinction. Availability of a large number of opportunities to resort to just and fair means in order to attain that dignity and distinction is what democracy is all about. That is what our constitution is all about. And that is what makes life wholesome and worth living in a true and vibrant democracy.
Quote of mine there on Mother Teresa, which is the most powerful woman in the world. Now I must tell you what its context was. In one of our many conversations over 23 years, we were discussing the conflict in many parts of the world, and also at that time the troubled state in Ethiopia. And then this was the time of the Cold War and the big powers, and the fact was that aid was actually not reaching the abject poor in that country, as it often does not in many countries. So I said, Mother Teresa, you're the most powerful woman in the world. Why can't you use your power to lessen war and bring peace? To which she laughed and said, where? If I was the most powerful woman in the world, then I would have to take sides because I would get stuck in politics. And if I took sides, I would stop loving. So that was the totality of that particular last sentence that has been used there. I think because of the Mother Teresa virus in me, it matters to me that every last election agent of ours, every last official we send, even in such a difficult state as Jharkhand, comes back home safe. Every security force that we employ on duty, I would like them to return safe. I would like to see, and we have tried to ensure, that even in that troubled state, we have had a reasonably tranquil election where almost 60% of its voting population came out to express their mandate.
my knowledge about Mother Teresa, of course, limited. But I met, you see, few occasion. And then after her passed away, I had opportunity to visit her center in Calcutta. I really very much impressed. I found there Mother Teresa's physical no longer there, but her spirit and her compassion, hers or the words, dedication to serve people, particularly poor people, is very much alive there. There are two levels of compassion. One, biological factor. That's basically very much mixed with attachment. So that's very limited and biased. That kind of compassion cannot extend towards your enemy or neutral people. But with help of intelligence, through training, then that compassion reach second level. With help of intelligence, with help of wisdom, that compassion then unbiased, because of unbiased, very objective, therefore that compassion can extend towards our enemy. That's a true compassion. So therefore, that without religious belief, I feel it can develop. That's my fundamental sort of belief.